What it do, baby? You know, it's been another random amount of time. I keep saying I'm gonna make a weekly video, but it never happens in a week. I'm sorry, you know. I'm not the best at sticking my word, but we're back. I'm sorry I vanished for so long.
100 years passed and my brother and I discovered the new avatar, an airbender named Aang.
I've been in quarantine. I got my puppy here with me. So, you know, she keeps me busy. Come on, jump, jump up. Oh, good girl. Oh, hello. But I'm ready. I'm here to make videos, you know what I'm saying? So I got this new light. I don't know if you noticed, but I'm looking real bright today. Skin's looking pretty good, I'd like to think. I don't know. Hopefully I'm not breaking out, you know. But today, we're talking about alcohol. If you're like me, you know, you like to go out, you like to party, but you don't like to get fat. So today, we are going to talk about how to get fucked up without fucking up your diet.
Stones on the rocks and I'm ready for some shots. The women come around every time I'm pouring shots. Their panties hit the ground every time I give them shots. So cups in the air, everybody let's take shots.
And before anyone says anything, no, this is not an excuse for me to drink alone in the middle of the day, okay? This is for science. Cue the intro. So there's one thing you have to keep in mind when you're on a diet and you're drinking alcohol. At the end of the day, a calorie is a calorie. And to lose weight, you have to be in a calorie deficit. There's no getting around it. You will not lose weight if you're in a surplus. It's just not possible. It's not how life works. So there's two things you should do if you're going to drink. One, plan ahead. Know how many calories of alcohol you're going to drink that night. Use MyFitnessPal. Do mental math if you're a weirdo to figure it out. But just know how much you're going to be drinking. And then two, allot yourself those calories for that day. So rather cut out lunch, cut out breakfast, maybe shrink how much you eat for those meals. But whatever you do, just make sure you stay in a deficit and you'll be fine. And I know what you're saying, if I don't eat a lot, I'm going to be hungry. How am I supposed to drink and eat? And the simple fact is you can't, okay? You can't have your cake and eat it too.
This house is a fucking prison on planet bullshit. In the galaxy of this sucks camel dicks!
But there is a plus to this. We all know that when you're fasted and you drink, alcohol tends to hit harder, so there's that. You're gonna be extra turnt because you didn't get to eat dinner or lunch or whatever. So enjoy that. You're welcome. Free tidbit. So one thing to know about drinking alcohol is that your body metabolizes alcohol much the same way it would a poison. And by that I mean it has no ability to store alcohol. You can't store it as fat, you can't store it as glycogen, you can't store it as anything, okay? So when you ingest alcohol, your body focuses 100% of its effort on burning that alcohol out of your system. This is bad because your body completely stops burning other things. So if you eat a bowl of rice, let's say, and then do a shot of alcohol, your body's not going to burn any of those carbs. It's going to store all the carbs as fat, and it's going to focus instead on burning that alcohol out of your system. So when you're drinking, you want to avoid binge eating at all costs because anything you eat before or after is going to end up stored as fat because, like I said, your body's going to be focused on burning the alcohol out of your system. This is especially true for fats because studies show that fat oxidation goes down when you're intoxicated. Another thing to keep in mind is that alcohol lowers our inhibitions. We all know that. Like, when I'm drunk, I don't have a lot of self-control personally. It's kind of embarrassing, but it is what it is. Studies have actually shown, though, that when you drink, it can make you feel more hungry than you are. So, keep that in mind when you're going out to drink, because I know personally, when I get drunk, the first thing I do after I leave the club is one, get in an Uber, because I'm responsible and I don't drink and drive, and two, I tell that Uber driver to book it to the closest grease pit, whether it be Taco Bell or McDonald's, and get me some food, because I'm hungry. I say it a lot nicer though, I'm not a dick, I promise. But the point is, eating these big meals after you get drunk, especially big fatty meals or places like McDonald's and stuff, is horrible because all of that is going to get stored as fat. There is no better way to get new fat on your body than to binge eat after an alcohol binge. Don't do it. Avoid it at all costs. If you don't have self-control and you're dieting, don't drink because you're going to end up cheating on your diet and just ruining all the progress you've made. So alcohol can also affect your testosterone levels. It really depends on how much you're drinking, though. So studies have found that when you have 2 to 3 drinks, it can show an actual moderate increase in testosterone, which is why we sometimes associate a raised libido level with drinking alcohol. But let's be honest, you didn't come here to find out if it's okay to drink 2 or 3 cups of wine at night with your dinner. You came here to find out if you can turn up and still turn out results. And the answer is, kind of.
Oh, say less.
So when you drink in excess, it's going to affect your testosterone rather drastically. One study that showed this was where they took blood from drunk people in the ER, and they noticed that the men had a 43% decrease in their testosterone levels compared to a test control group. Women, on the other hand, showed a 5 times increase in testosterone. They believe that this is because of alcohol's inhibitory effects on testicular testosterone, aka if you're a woman and you don't have testicles, then you don't really need to worry about drinking lowering your testosterone. Men, on the other hand, you do. But it's only short term. So as long as you're not drinking every single day like a psychopath, then you should be okay. So drinking alcohol can absolutely have an effect on muscle growth. Studies have consistently shown that when you ingest alcohol, it's going to have a pretty drastic effect on muscle protein synthesis. Most studies have been done in mice and rats, but they always show consistent results. The one reputable study that I found that was done on humans showed up to a 37% decrease in muscle protein synthesis when alcohol was ingested, and this could last up to 8 hours. The one saving grace is that it shows that when you ingest protein along with the alcohol, it can drop to only a 24% decrease, which is bad, but it's not as bad as 37. So basically what I'm telling you is that if you plan on turning up when you're leaving the gym, make your protein shake, and then just go ahead and, you know, put a shot of vodka and then shake it up, take it down the hatch. It'll be great. It's gonna help out a lot. I'm basically a bartender. Delicious. Like testosterone, though, for some reason this only seems to affect men. So women, once again, you are in the clear on this one. You don't have to worry about muscle growth being affected by drinking alcohol. Men, you do. So drinking alcohol isn't going to impact you a ton when it comes to muscle recovery. Studies have shown that the occasional night out really will not hurt you. But when you start drinking excessively, it can have some negative impacts on things like your cortisol levels, obviously your cognitive abilities. So everything in moderation, that's really what it comes down to with alcohol. You know, it does have some negative impacts on you when it comes to fitness, but they're all really short-term things. So a single night out, as long as you account for the calories and stuff like that, isn't going to hurt you. So don't be scared to go out and have a good time. You'll be fine, I promise. And even, you know, sometimes it's good to cheat on your diet. It's good to go out and let loose. You know, you've been dieting 2 weeks, whatever. Have a cheat day. Go out, have a good time with your friends, you know. Diets won't work if you're super strict with them, so don't be afraid to have a good time. But that's enough of the boring stuff. We're going to go ahead and get into drinking now. I've bought a bunch of different kinds of alcohol, and I'm going to run through all the different kinds of alcohol I have, and I'm going to talk to you about how many calories are in it, if I think it's a good choice to drink or not a good choice to drink for when you go out and you're on a diet. Some of these are like spirits, so I'm going to talk about if I think you should just drink them straight, you know, toughen up. And then I'm going to talk about some low-calorie mixers I have, or that I personally use when I go out and drink to save calories. And we're going to get progressively drunker as this video goes on. So I hope you guys are ready for a good time. I'm ready to drink. I don't have a problem, and this is for science. Don't forget that.
Science rules.
Okay, so first up we have bread water, aka beer, as some people like to call it. Personally, I think beer is disgusting. I'm sorry, Bill. For those of you who don't know, Bill is my housemate, roommate, whatever you call it. And he makes beer, so sorry for saying that. I'm sure your beer is delicious. But me personally, not a big beer guy. So beer comes in at about 156 calories per 12 ounces. But a lot of that comes from not just alcohol, but carbs. Because you got to think how beer is made. And so just keep that in mind that when you're drinking beer, you're getting alcohol and carbs and sugar. You can avoid some of these calories by drinking light beer, but that's really lame. Like, if you're going to drink light beer, just don't drink at all.
Slow! They called you slow! How dare you call me that!
Please don't make fun of my shotgun speed. You know, I never went to college, and I just turned 21, so I'm still working on it. Next up, we have hard cider, which is basically beer, but it's made with fruit, and it tastes good. So, that good taste does come at a cost, as these come in at about 165 calories on average per 12 ounces. And they're pretty tasty, but you have to remember that they do have a lot of sugar in them, and that's why they're so sweet. Next up, we got Smirnoff Ice. You guys can call me soft, but I love this stuff, okay? It tastes good. When I drink, I want what I'm drinking to taste good. So this is usually what I go with if I'm not dieting. But when I'm dieting, absolutely not. Okay, this comes in about 221 calories per 12 ounces. This is literally so packed full of sugar. It has about 6 teaspoons of sugar in every 12 ounces. This is 24 ounces, so just think about how many calories this is. And before anyone's like, Michael, you're gonna get fat making this video, okay? Today's my cheat day. I saved it for this for a reason. I'm using my cheat day on you guys, so I hope you feel loved.
You suck!
We got a lot more alcohol to drink tonight, so I'll put this off to the side for when I make my protein shake tonight. So next up, we've got the literal holy grail of low alcohol content drinks. Hard seltzers. Personally, I'm a White Claw guy. But hard seltzers are absolutely the best drink you can be drinking if you're not drinking spirits while on a diet. This puppy has about 100 calories in it, like 2 grams of carbs. It's got water in it, so you can lie to yourself, say you're hydrating and getting drunk. They're great, okay? You can never go wrong with the White Claw. You know what Trevor says.
Ain't no laws when you're drinking claws, baby.
Okay, so our final kind of low alcohol content drink is going to be the Four Loko. I say kind of low alcohol content because honestly, Four Loko has a lot more alcohol than like a hard seltzer or beer, but it has a lot less than liquor does. We've all had a Four Loko before. I don't have to tell you this isn't healthy. Like, just look at this thing. Does this look healthy to you? Like, even without knowing what's in it. This sucker's got about 660 calories in it. Literally a ton of sugar. Just avoid Four Lokos at all costs. Also, I'm not going to chug this because I don't want to die and or black out. So, on to the next one. So, kind of in between for me, between like beer and liquor is like wine. You know, the alcohol content's kind of a little bit higher. But let's be honest, nobody's like, I'm going to the club, I want some wine. So, we're just not going to talk about wine. We're going to skip it. I'm going to go straight into tequila. So, I have this right here. Tequila. Tequila has about 64 calories per shot, which is probably the lowest you're going to get out of any alcohol, to be honest. It's naturally sweet because of the agave, so you don't really need to chase it. You just get yourself a lime to bite into, some salt, whatever, however you guys do it. As far as mixed drinks, I'm just going to be honest, there's no real way to make a margarita healthy. So if you're drinking tequila, drink it straight, do shots, get you a lime, some salt. You know the deal. Okay, next up, we got whiskey. Personally, I have some Gentleman Jack here, but I personally hate whiskey. I feel like we all have a story where we got super drunk drinking one kind of alcohol, we blacked out, we threw up, and now we have PTSD, and every time we drink that alcohol, we get sick. That's whiskey for me, but I'm drinking it for you guys. It's got about 105 calories per shot. I'm not much of a straight guy myself.
Ha! Gay!
Okay, pause. I am. You guys know what I mean. I don't drink this stuff straight, but I like to mix it. So I have some Coke Zero and some Jack. Everybody's had Jack and Coke before, but if you want to save some calories, the best thing to do is to just sub out your normal soda for some diet soda and save yourself the calories. Next up, we have gin, which comes in at about 110 calories a shot. Personally, I hate gin. I think it's disgusting. I would never drink it straight. So a low-calorie option for you to drink is to just get some club soda, some sparkling water, you know, tonic water, whatever. Some lime juice, some mint leaves. Make yourself a mojito. There you go. Low-calorie gin drink. Okay. So next up, we got rum coming in at about 97 calories a shot. Personally, I don't drink this straight, so a low-calorie mixer option is club soda, diet 7-Up, or Sprite. They're kind of interchangeable. Lime juice, and if you're bougie, throw some mint leaves in there. But yeah, you know, rum's not bad. It's not great. It's a lot of these liquors are kind of around the same calorie count, so it comes down to a lot of preference. So vodka comes in at about 97 calories a shot. Vodka is my personal favorite. You can drink it straight. You can mix it with diet Sprite for low calories. You can get low calorie juices if you want. I would test a lot more liquors tonight, but I've been in Africa for about 9 months and my alcohol tolerance is very low. So I'm trying not to get alcohol poisoning. But this is the end of the video, you know. I'm pretty intoxicated, so I'm going to order some fast food. I mean,
ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
Why are you running? Why are you running?
What it do, baby? It's the next day. You know, I don't feel too bad. This morning I woke up, my stomach felt horrible though. I don't think mixing 9 alcohols is ever a good idea, but I did it for you guys and for science. I just want to say that if you're going out, honestly, you should just stay away from low alcohol content drinks. The calorie to alcohol content ratio is just not good. You're not going to get a lot of bang for your buck. I would stick to straight liquor. I would drink it straight if you can. And if you can't, stick to low-calorie mixers, diet soda, things of that nature. I hope you guys learned a thing or two in this video. If you did, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, as well as share it with a friend. You can follow me on Instagram at Michael Barnes Fitness, where I post all our travel pics as well as fitness tips and tricks. And until next time, everybody, stay strong.